Yeah. All right, so game two at Forge Fest versus Ben. Hey, man.
Hey, yeah, mate.
All right, takes three lists.
We got 10 Necron Immortals with Ghost Blasters, Storm Tech, Field Tech. We've also got 10 Necron Immortals with Tesla, Lance Tech, Field Tech, 2 Overlords, War Scythe, Mind Shackles, 2 plus Resorbs, Stalker, Heat Ray, and I've got in reserve. I've got 2 units of 10 Immortals with Haywire Techs and 2 Monoliths.
And he's got this is the Forge World base thing?
Yeah, Forge World base.
It looks really cool. Yeah. Alright, so I've done pretty simple. I'm about to infiltrate my genies, but just deploy my army there, going forward. Alright. Alright, so this game's a great example of the different type of like philosophies that people had when they went into this tournament. So Ben, he brought in a 20-hour 20 list, as in he spent 0 credits using the comp system that we're using. And he still had a lot of the cool toys that you could do. You know, you've got the Mind Shackle, Scarab Lords, squads that teleport around, 2 monoliths, the double shot melter doohickey. And that's still that uses in according to the comp system 0 points. Tyranids, there was one other Tyranid player that went there. I don't think we could have come up with a list that used 0 points, because every monstrous creature in essence is 1 point. And if you take 55 models, so any more than 54 models, you also spend 1 point. So I just went, I'm not going to even bother trying, I'll just spend around 6, because you're allowed to say spend 8, I only spent 6, and I thought I had a reasonably balanced list. The other Tyranid player, he took way more warriors, because I took a whole bunch of shrikes, which are warriors in essence. He took a lot of warriors and gene stealers and things like that, and he still got pinged because he took one monstrous creature, the Exocrine. And that's 1 point. And he couldn't get away from that. Anyway, so the minds, the ideas here, it's you'll either take a 20 out of 20 list and just draw or not lose too big in your games. And my idea was I was just trying to win all my games. And I'll take a not super, super hard list, but not a really, really easy list. Anyway, actually paying attention to the game here. for my turn one, it was just me moving forward, didn't really do anything. Ben's, his turn one involved him teleporting behind my army. Now, you kind of just saw that there. He got first blood by killing all the gene stealers. But by teleporting and bunching up, it meant the Exocrine. You can see that I made sure there was no one in front of the Exocrine when I shot. It got a beautiful hit, direct hit, and killed most of that squad. And then the Shrikes made an 8-inch charge. Fleet is awesome. And tied them up for these. So right now I'm fighting the last two guys, which is the Lord and the Cryptic. I eventually kill them both and spread out on top of their bodies so they can't res. Once he realized that he didn't really do that much damage, I think he caused one wound on my Turvagon, he teleports straight back to his side of the board, and the game now starts proper, I guess, because my Bivores snipe out the last Cryptek that teleports, and so now Ben, he is stuck in essence on his side of the board. So where he is, the two monoliths, that both monoliths actually immobilize, and so the two monoliths, which are now immobilized, a walk-on squad here and of warriors, another squad of warriors with the Lord, and another squad of warriors here. That's all it is, and they're stuck now on this side here. So they're never getting this relic. And we're playing objectives, so there's a few objectives around. His monolith's actually sitting on top of one of them. And so that's pretty much what the game plan is here. Mine is grab that relic and give it to my Turvagon eventually. and then rush forward with absolutely everything, including the Exocrine, because my game plan for Exocrine was sit in the middle, because he's only got 24-inch range. All of Sharpie's guns are, in essence, 24 inches. So if he's in range of me, I'm in range of him. And it's kind of like a paladin, in essence. You just want to get into the middle there. Here, my Hive Tyrant shoots a whole bunch of guys and goes in for the charge. Ben did a really, really clever thing here, where the one guy that rezzed, he put him in terrain, and he was now the closest, so my Hive Tyrant had to charge him. Unfortunately, he still won combat, and they all ran off the board. Or I just chased them out, I can't remember. Anyway, Hive Tyrant here, now three wounds, looking towards the last two squads. My Shrikes finally kill off that squad, so it was a bit unlucky. I actually wanted them to be killed a turn earlier, because right now that my big squad is just going to get Linebreaker. It's going for the Vanguard Strike Linebreaker thing. Here I'm just trying to kill the last of his troops so he can't score his point and I can score my point, which is up in the top here. You can just see it's completely surrounded full of Gaunts. Unfortunately, on his very last shot, he grounds my Hive Tyrant, and it prevents me from contesting that last objective. I do manage to, with my Carnifex here, destroy this, what's it called, the Monolith. But I don't care, there's still one troop right on top of that objective, so unfortunately I don't get a big 20 win. I think I won 17-5 or something like that. So Ben did a really good job in not getting a huge loss.